In today's short video, I'll be going through installing TinyXP onto this HP computer. We've got all the bits we need here. Let's get started. I'm only really going to be doing a short video today. It's nothing major, but this is mostly just an experiment. So what's basically been going on is I've caught COVID-19, those of you probably know already, and I'm quite sick, but it's fine, I'm improving, and I want to say that I've been stuck here for about 4 or 5 days now. It's not ideal. I don't really want to be here, but you know, got to be safe. So it's an interesting turn of events, really. I did not expect myself to come down with it so quite so sudden, but I have, and I can't do anything about that now, unfortunately. So just taping the drive down just to prevent it from flopping around. But we're going to try and avoid covering up the breathing hole on the side, which is right here. So I may sound like a nut sometimes, but I know what I'm doing. I'm going to be quite precise with this. But yeah, don't be worried, I'm getting better. So I'll be back doing the normal stuff shortly, and I'll be going places, you know, getting more stuff to tinker with, perhaps. I don't know why I brought many different types of tape with me. I don't even needed the masking tape. It doesn't tear anything as you take it off. This is why masking tape's so good for holding stuff like this down, but it's not heat resistant. So that's not ideal. I don't know what else I could use. I mean, I've got this stuff which is quite good, this double-sided yellow tape. Let's get that closer to the action there. I'm not sure. We'll come back to that later, until I can be reassured it's going to hold. Yeah, that's pretty secure. Cool, right. Now we can get onto the actually fun stuff. So there's our CD. We're going to use that CD. Oh yeah, I put the correct wireless card back in this HP. Of course. Imminent failure. Yeah, I'm gonna say cap, because this hard drive I don't think had smart built into it. Because it's from 1997, of course, correct me if I'm wrong. But since this is only temporary, I don't care, so we're just gonna ignore. Now, something I have been familiar with Hewlett-Packard and TinyXP, is it does not like being, it doesn't like being installed on HP products. Oh. Okay. I think let's try booting from like F12 or something. Assuming this has an F12 menu. Now it's trying to boot from PXE. This is not going to plan. F8 to change menu. Oh, it's escape. That's positive. Yes! Okay. Right, what we want is tiny XP, micro XP. We want 4. Assuming I did click on 4. I don't trust it. Windows Executive. I haven't seen that since Windows 1. Which I'm taking a chance because I need the like tiniest operating system possible because this hard drive is only 2 GB.
Yeah.
Wow, imagine what you could have done with 2,000 MB back in the day. I would assume a lot. All those pictures. I think this is quite slow because it has to find a bunch of preloaded SCSI drivers. I think that's what it's trying to do. QLogic. I've got a couple of QLogic fiber cards. I've been trying to get rid of them, but I don't want to throw them away because they might still, well, actually might still work as a bit of a an overstatement. I can't actually test them, so any suggestions as to what I could do with those server grade fiber optic cards would be brilliant. I hate glossy screens sometimes, but this one I can give an excuse to because it's old. Yeah, this is nice. This is actually mint condition, HP. That's the model right there. The full model. I just call it the DV4000 because I can't be bothered to call its full name. It's got all kinds of buttons at the top, media, control, and all that. It's got sound, like Altec Lancing. And you know I love my Altec Lancing. RIP DV6. JBL, I really like their sound as well, because their speakers in that XPS over there, oh man, those speakers are brilliant, even better than the DV6, but I prefer the DV6's speakers because they're nice. And apologies for the voice, I do have a sore throat because of, I caught the Bobid 15. Don't think I'm allowed to say its full name on YouTube, so, but you'd know what I'm talking about. I don't like being stuck in here, but, you know, you've got to keep people safe. Other things I could probably talk about. That pile over there needs to be gone through. In the box at the bottom is a motherboard for a Mitsubishi computer that's got to be taken and put back in the case, then I can deal with the computer as a big piece. There's a MacBook in the brown box, and those two laptops need to be fixed. And that box up there is empty, but I'll put some iPads I have in there soon, because I don't want them anymore, and I'd rather not have them in the shelf. So yeah, that's a bonus, I suppose. Is it a bonus? No, I don't know. Ooh. XP Professional. Suppose. I'm just gonna wing it. And at this point, I'm not gonna bore you with the installation process, because that's normally very, very slow. So, I'll get back when that's done. Well, it's initializing the configuration. Is that a good thing? I don't know. Black screen. Ooh, HP. Do you think I need to hit enter now? I don't think that worked. Right, I'm gonna try again and see what I can get up to. I've got good news, it's installed this time. We've got a working mouse pointer at least. So that's a good sign. Aside from that, I'm still waiting on the very slow hard drive to make its mind up. Okay, cool, we've got that. It's a progress bar. It's got its own little built-in 7-zip tool. That's cool. I did not know that was a feature. Again, I won't bore you with it doing all this, and come back when something interesting is on the screen. Okay, it's 100% decompression. We've got another box, which is done. Okay. I wonder what's now. Microsoft Windows, please wait. Please wait a moment while the welcome disc loads. Cue that awesome little melody it plays. Oh man, the Commodore CD32. No, the CDTV. That'd be something I want to get into, but it's so damn expensive. Well, Commodore as a whole is difficult to get to. Same with Amiga and Acorn and just basically anything cool. So I've taken up the cheaper side. Wii. And no, not W-I-I. W-E-E-E. Or Waste Electrical and Electronic Equipment. Because you can pick that stuff up dime a dozen. Still fun to play around with. I mean, this was free. And it's mint condition, so... I ain't complaining. Disc drive's having some... It's having a moment. Ooh. Yeah, I don't know what the disc drive is doing, it's... It's just moving the laser backwards and forwards, making noise. It's an easy way to waste time, I suppose. The sooner the days go by, the quicker the better. And I assume all my sound is coming through the microphone just below my mouth. If not, the microphone at the bottom of the phone. Instead. Yes. I think it's there. I'm not sure. It would either be... No, the top of the phone is the earpiece. Yeah. Windows XP doesn't normally do this, I don't think. Unless it's being deployed via an image, perhaps. Ow. Just punch myself in the face with a ThinkPad. This thing is actually really heavy. Despite being made of plastic, it makes more. Yeah, my ThinkPad is not like most ThinkPads. It makes creaky noises. Yeah, that's not normal.
It proves it was never built properly.
But yeah, I digress. That thing is on its last legs, and I really need to just move on. Shame, really, as I was looking forward to doing the MSATA mod. Perhaps this can be a candidate for extreme computer restorations if I can be bothered. We'll see. I've already got two other candidates. I've got the Acer that's in there, I've got that HP, and I've got the Acer down there with all the stickers on it. So, those will be interesting to see. Extreme computer restorations. Looking forward to it, personally. And, at the same time, I don't need to frantically get ready to move house, because we're not doing that anymore. It's been extended. Oh, lovely. We're installing the devices. So, is it going to be installing all the drivers off the CD? I think. Off of the drive, one of the two. Either way, I'm not going to bore you with that. Okay, so that's done. I think. No. Networking components. I don't think it'll get very far, but I haven't really tried Centrino wireless adapters with Mini XP before, but I have definitely tried Broadcom, and that did not work. So, see if Intel fares any better. Okay, we're just performing the final tasks, so we're installing the start menu items, registers, components. Registers, components? Huh? I don't understand what that means. Could someone enlighten me to what that means, please? Thank you. But yeah, looks like this is going to be another mostly automated task. Okay, it's finished doing that. Don't know what its next move is going to be. It's either going to probably shut itself down, or do something else. Shut itself down. Ooh, experience. What's its next move? Nobody knows. Gonna take that long just to light the mouse pointer. This is going to be a meme and a half. I really shouldn't put the DV4000 through this, but it's the only hard drive I've got, so until I buy more drives, it's kind of stuck like that. Yeah, probably gonna do something when this actually loads. Oh. Well, that was pretty quick. Look at the size of the screen. They've just crammed it. This is like 800 by 600 resolution. This has to be like 640 by 480 or something. Maybe even 240 by 620 or something, like really, really tiny. No, that'd be going too far, surely. But I'm going to assume it's 640 by 480. User message.exe. Oh well. Or no inf. Okay. That is none of my concern. Is that it? Normally there's a little stage it goes through, it boots itself up and installs the final components and then restarts itself. So, Judging by that's wishes, I'm not going to touch anything. Well, I do wonder what this means. Yeah, that's much better. Is that it? I don't know, I'm just gonna leave that doing its thing and I'll come back if it does restart itself or not. Okay, looks like that was the final installation, I think. I think there was supposed to be more installed on here, but because of that lack of space, it couldn't install everything. But we have confirmed you can indeed install Windows XP on a 2 GB hard drive. Just it is severely crippled, and I don't know what you're going to do with 398 MB, but that's of course completely up to you. So thanks for watching, and I'll get back to you in the next video with random shenanigans.